Hey, hey people, Seth here. Today, I'll be reviewing The Adventure Zone Book 2, Murder on the Rockport, written by the McElroy brothers and their art slave, Carrie Peach, who's currently living in their basement, chained to a post.
Just joking, this madman. I wanted to give this before episode message because I not only voiced Merle and Avi this episode, but I also did the sound design. This is the first of many episodes, I pray, that will have my touch. Many thanks to the entire crew, but especially to Xander, for throwing me the bone when I asked for it, letting me handle sound design. I hope you all enjoy. Madman out.
Now, where were we? Oh, right.
The following is a non-profit fan dub. The Adventure Zone is owned by the McElroys, Carrie Peach, and First Second Books. Links in the description to support the official Elite Spring Adventurers.
Magnus Burnside's Merle Highchurch. Taco. The Bureau of Balance is a volunteer organization. I won't force you to join, but if you do, you'll become part of something grand. Something important. The work we do here is fraught with peril. I can't promise it will be easy, but I know you are equal to the task. I know the last 24 hours have probably been very confusing for you. You may have many questions.
Like, what was that crap you just made us drink?
And I'm going to answer them. But first, I need you to hand over the gauntlet so that we can destroy it.
Yeah, we could do that. But maybe you should tell us about this little organization of yours first.
The Bureau of Balance, of which I am the director, has a singular purpose. And that is to collect, well, let's call them weapons of mass destruction. I suppose you could call us a disarmament organization. Dedicated to finding and neutralizing dangerous magical artifacts.
Can't we watch as you hurl it into the fires of Mount Doom?
Not sure where that is, but no, it's not that simple. It's actually taking us quite some time to develop anything capable of destroying an object this powerful.
No need for the hard sell, Madam Director. I think we like what we see so far. But you see, we worked really hard to get this gauntlet.
That's the kind of business we're in, ma'am. We get stuff and people pay us for it.
Oh, you will be paid. You will be paid very handsomely.
Yeah, that's the kind of thing people say when by paying us, they really mean they're going to kill us.
No, that's not how the Bureau of Balance operates. It's payment upon obliteration of the gauntlet, not you.
Davenport! Davenport?
This is the part where you hand over the gauntlet?
Don't you mean gauntlet over the hand? No, because it's flesh, the glove, and... forget it.
Works for me? It's getting on my last nerve.
Davenport. Davenport. Davenport.
And then that happened.
That was so cool!
Yeah, I bet it looked awesome.
Pay them in, Davenport. Pay them for a good day's work.
It was more than a day.
More like a week, right?
We had a couple of planning days, and we had to get the supply chain in order.
10? Should we go with 10 days?
Yes, all right, 10 days! Davenport, pay them for their 10 days of work.
Davenport! Great, that's done. Now, what the hell was in those vials?
Yeah, and what's with your weird yet beautiful pet in a ginormous tank?
And I'm not saying you're full of it or anything, but if these artifacts were hot shit, why don't I remember hearing about them?
What we do would not be possible without the Voidfish. The war, calamity, and turmoil you can now remember was a direct result of dangerous magical artifacts. When these items were crafted and word of their power spread, everyone wanted them. Every kingdom in the land, every political organization, mercenary guild, religious community, they all mounted their efforts to claim the artifacts for their own. That led to a war the likes of which the world had never seen. And the only way to end that war was to make everyone forget the artifacts existed. When information is fed to the void fish, knowledge of that item disappears from the world. And when you drink from the void fish's ichor, that knowledge returns to you.
Ichor?
The liquid in the tank.
You made us drink jellyfish poop?!
Would you rather go back to hearing static?
Absolutely!
I, for one, would drink liters of poop to know the truth.
Can we please get this man some liters of poop?
Wait! Are you offering us a regular gig? Doing what, exactly?
We would like to hire the three of you as reclaimers.
I love that track! Oh, I would walk 500 miles!
And I would walk 500 more!
No. Reclaimers. You see, our organization is made up of three divisions. The first gathers information on the artifacts. They are known as the Seekers. The next...
Oh, I know, they're called the Beaters!
And then the Keepers!
And the ones who grab the snitch! The snitch grabbers!
No, the Reclaimers. The Seekers are not permitted to collect the artifacts. The Reclaimers are. That's the job I'm offering you.
Do we get a license to kill?
I don't...
How about a license to chill?
That brings us to the third section, the Regulators. Anyone who uses information gathered about the artifacts for their own whim, or who wields an artifact even once, will be hunted down and properly dealt with by the Regulators. You've already met our best Regulator, Killian.
Who?
Friend Killian!
I remember you from the first book!
Please, Magnus, Merle, Taco, join us. The very existence of everything we know and love may hang in the balance.
Is there dental?
Yes.
Cool.
We're in.
Davenport? Gentlemen, you are hereby accepted as fully fledged members of our order, and we are proud to present you with these bracers of balance.
You people are really into alliteration.
These have been tailor-made for each of you, and once you put them on, they can never be removed.
I'm worried about bracer stink. What's the policy on that? Is there some kind of detergent?
Every initiate is issued a special brush, so you can just get right in there and do some grouting.
Gross. Who would ever...
It means so much that you showed up to join in welcoming us to the club.
A regulator is always on hand when a reclaimer joins. It's our way of saying, I now know your face. That'll make it easier to hunt you down.
Oh.
Kind of an aggressive workplace environment you've got here.
So that's it? Just one crummy bracer? Where's the cool weapons and magic duds?
Yeah, we were thinking we'd get more than that.
You will take these three tokens to our artificer. He will provide you with additional items.
I hope I get a dog.
There are no dogs on the moon!
It's for their own good. We worry that they'll run off the edge chasing a stick or something. And let's not forget...
Finally, is it going to be a check? Cash? Promissory note?
Oh, good. A fantasy trapper keeper.
That will guide you as you get to know the moon base. As your new home.
Sure. I'm seeing maps, room service menu, layout of our rooms. Wait, room? Singular? I have to share with these guys?
Cookies!
Looks like we have to see Leon the Artificer first. Another damned dome.
Architecturally speaking, it's really not the best use of space.
Welcome! I am Leon, the Artificer, and this is my...
I am really jonesing for a gumball.
No, it's...
A gashapon machine!
No, This is my...
vending machine from Shenmue!
No. Fine. It's a big gashapon machine full of magical items.
Isn't the whole point of the organization to keep people from getting their hands on this kind of thing?
Yes, it's true that it's against the strictures of our order to specifically give our members magical armaments to use in the field. So instead, we leave it to fate. Yeah, it's kind of an ethical workaround, but what you gonna do? Anybody feeling lucky? Wanna take a spin?
Me, I'll go first!
Oh, that's the True Heart Clasp.
Oh!
It looks very dashing.
Pulling it off.
Anybody wanna go next?
I'll give it a try. I have a coin.
It goes right into the machine.
Right, here you go.
No, you have to put it in the machine yourself. There's this whole thing like fate, chance, divine intervention.
So where does the coin go?
Into the coin-shaped hole.
Excellent! Where?
Right there, front of the machine.
Good news! I've solved your puzzle.
You're halfway home. Now just crank the handle to the right.
Sorry, man, it won't crank!
Because you're cranking it to the left! You have to crank it to the right!
I did an insight check. It leaned toward the left.
Just crank it to the right!
Oops.
That is the Ring of Chilling Frost. It defends you from frost attacks. But most importantly, if you are holding any beverages, the ring makes it very frosty and refreshing.
So, a koozie ring.
Magic dog, magic dog, magic dog, magic dog, magic dog!
You hold in your hands Rail Splitter.
Oh.
It is a very powerful axe that can chop down any tree with a single swing. Since it's a +1 battle axe, it adds +1 to your attack and damage.
Sweet! Okay, that's it for the pretend money. Where do we spend the real stuff?
If you look right here, in your orientation timetable, that should be your next stop.
Cool. But before we go, can you tell me...
Holy shit! An Umbra Staff!
So... yes?
It's called an Umbra Staff. An arcane focus created by an order of artificers called the Umbra Wizards.
The Umbro Wizards? Known for their baggy shorts and great soccer skills?
Umbra. They specialized in creating magical items that look like normal everyday objects. It consumes the magical essence of defeated magic users. So for most spellcasters, that means their magic focus. These are quite rare. Take good care of it. And it would probably be a good idea not to let Garfield catch a glimpse of it.
Who?
You'll see.
Welcome to Fantasy Costco! Here you can buy amazing items to help you on your quest. I am Garfield, the Deals Warlock!
Like the lasagna cat?
Who's to say?
Yeah, but like, what's your deal?
I'm Garfield, the Deals Warlock! Ah, what an intriguing bumper shoot you have there.
Don't worry your furry little self about that. You're providing us with shit, not the other way around.
For now. So, you must be the recent hires. First day on the moon. Always great to see new blood. New blood? See, it's very funny if you know eggs and blood is currency. Oh, just kill me. Allow me to suggest, for Taco, the Wand of Switcheroo! Only 450 gold!
Throw in this unlimited pasta pass and you've got a deal.
For Magnus, the Phantom Fist! A steal at 500 gold!
Cool!
For Merle, the Scuttle Buddy! 400 gold, but a deal at any price.
I shall name him Ted.
And for all three of you, these lovely stones of Fast
speech.
Standard issue, mandatory purchase.
Doesn't standard issue mean they should be free?
And that total comes to...
Weird that he knew we had exactly 1,800 gold.
Only good at participating Olive Gardens. What a rip.
And I got this cool axe. Cuts down any tree with one swipe. Doesn't it look awesome?
It's a stone of far speech, Magnus. I can't see you. Listen, we're gonna have to interrupt break time. Some real bad news just came in. We gotta send you on another mission.
What, like tomorrow?
Like now.
We haven't even been to our room!
I had a nippy nap.
I booked a kelp wrap at 4:30!
I'm sorry, gentlemen, it can't be helped. A few days ago, our seekers located another artifact. The weapon is even more powerful, more dangerous than the Phoenix Fire Gauntlet. We dispatched one of our reclaimers to retrieve it, a man named Lehman Kessler. After his initial report, Lehman violated protocol by not checking in at the required time. We fear he was unable to resist the thrall of the artifact.
Yeah, well, not everybody's Taco.
You are certainly correct there.
Well, I was getting you lot set up with HR. The Bureau sent one of my fellow regulators, Carrie Fangbattle, to recover Kessler from his last known location, the city of Rockport.
Did she find him?
Yeah, she found him. Wasn't breathing, but she found him.
Let me guess. No weapon.
No weapon.
Did they find anything?
A lot of blood.
Of course. Nobody ever dies of old age around you people.
Also a baggage car claim check. And a train ticket for the Rockport Limited.
So there's no chance the Rockport Limited is a chain clothing store?
It's a train that runs from Rockport to Eversummer through a mountain range called the Teeth.
We believe Lehman managed to secure passage. The luggage claim would indicate he was able to stash the artifact on the train.
But he got whacked before departure.
Well, pump the brakes for a second there, Director.
You said you used some hoodoo to make everyone forget the artifacts. If so, then how did someone know to kill the Vic and steal the weapon?
We don't know. We're hoping it was a horrible coincidence, because any other alternative is too terrifying to contemplate.
Never mind that. The train leaves in 2 hours. One of you must pose as Lehman Kessler.
Alas, poor Yogi. I knew him, horseradish. A fellow with ink on his chest.
We're in kind of a rush here. Don't really have time for auditions.
Fine, you could be Lehman Kessler.
Acting, thank you.
You need to look like you belong on a fancy train. Go change and then get your ass down to the hangar.
Wardrobe fitting. Now we're talking. All right, well, the rest of this orientation agenda's pretty much trashed. So much for Merle gets tattoo removed.
Who scheduled that? And why do they hate Kenny Chesney?
Pick out Kessler party disguises. Check. Report to new room in entry-level dorms. Check. Be underwhelmed. Check.
This can't be right. You must have brought us to the wrong place. Like, a moonbase jail cell.
What, are you crazy? This is perfect!
This is how they treat heroes? We bring them a deadly fire gauntlet, and they stick us in this dump? There's no way they can expect 3 people to live in this room.
They don't. They expect 4 people to live in this room.
Unbelievable!
Oh, I don't know. I kind of like his style.
Hey, fellas. These disguises are awesome!
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna need to live off campus.
Avi is waiting for you in the cannon bay. If you leave now, you should have just enough time to claim Kessler's luggage before the train leaves the station. You can use your bracers to call for transport sphere once you have the artifact in hand.
Hold up. Cannon bay?
Yes, I should warn you. The Bureau's main means of conveyance is pretty intense.
Shit, seriously? Those are transportation cannons?
Huh. I thought they were for moonbase to moonbase combat or something.
One more thing. The magic users who created this weapon, they're called Red Robes, named after the bright crimson garments they wear. As you might guess, they're incredibly dangerous individuals. If you come across any of them in this mission, It's imperative that you...
What's this one do?
Does this bad boy have nitrous?
Too fast, too furious.
This will be a lot more uncomfortable than your last ride. A lot of force.
Yeah. Let's just get this over with.
I don't see any cup holders.
But listen, it is vitally important that one of you sit in that seat. This is a fantasy air brake. If you pull it too early, the momentum disruption magic will fade. And that would be bad.
Sure, got it.
Tessa!
I'll drive next time.
Sure, fine.